Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today I will be reviewing Kyary Pamyu Pamyu's new album Japamyu. Before we get started, I want to remind you that this is simply my opinion on the album, and if you enjoy this video, don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more. Kyary Pamyu Pamyu is making a comeback 4 years after her third album Pika Pika Phantogen, and also 2 years after her first best of KPP Best. And if you think about it, it has been a pretty long break because it's been like 4 years since the last original album. And in between we got some songs, some singles and digital ones. But I have to admit, it was hard not to notice that compared to a few years back, she hasn't been as prolific or present as her debut days. And even if the best of sold quite well considering, I feel like there's been a slow decline in her popularity. And when this new album was announced, there wasn't as much hype for it as it used to be before. But either way, today the album was released on Spotify a day earlier compared to the physical copy, and I thought I shall give you guys my impressions and thoughts on this fourth album. And a Kyary Pamyu Pamyu album isn't one without the extreme cuteness in her music. And I remember in the past I was not a fan because it always felt too much, like you had a few good songs, but then when you listen to the albums, it felt like the worst sugar rush, you know, that would give you stomachache as well. And this album really goes for it, but this time it feels different. It feels less like a bad sugar rush. And this album knows exactly where to go, and this might sound familiar to you this year because I said the same thing about another album that came out a few months ago, and it was Future Pop by Perfume. And what do Kyary Pamyu Pamyu and Perfume have in common, you ask? Well, they are both produced by Nakata. And man, Nakata has been the biggest surprise of the year. He's killing it this year, and I ended up liking this album a lot more than I expected. And my expectations were really low. And of course, like I said, this album is a cute one. Don't expect her music to go dark. It's basically the same image and recipes. But I really like the way the album flows. It has a very self-aware atmosphere that surrounds it. And that makes the song and Kyary's voice actually bearable, if not really enjoyable at times. And I know I only reviewed the best stuff on the channel 2 years ago, but I have been the harshest critic of her music back in the days. And to say that I'm impressed by this album, trust me, I can't believe it either, but here we are. And I think the main reason why I'm into this album as much is because the annoying QTC melodies have been toned down to a point where you can actually enjoy the music, enjoy her voice. And there are so many songs that are very addictive, like I caught myself singing to one of them, like it's so fun. Like especially Harajuku Hiyahoi. Oh, this one is so good. And even in its own very cute universe, everything is quite enjoyable. And out of all the 10 songs part of the album, there's only two that I didn't like, and it's Enka Natrium, because this one felt too childish, both melody-wise and especially the singing. I felt like Kyary was going back to her old ways of being a little bit too high-pitched, and it gets on my nerves, so I was not into that. And also the Japamyu version of Sight and Co. I wasn't a fan of the song when it was on the best of, when it was released as a single. And this one on this album felt unnecessary, and I still don't like it. I can't quite believe that in 2018, I am saying that a Kyary Pamyu Pamyu album is a really good one. But here we are, and honestly, I still can't quite process the fact that Nakata has been on fire this year with some of his best work in years, and I'm glad it feels this way with all of the artists that he has produced this year. And of course, like I said, a Kyary Pamyu Pamyu album stays in the same lane that it used to be, and it's still very cute, and the album lasts 36 minutes, so it's not too long, and it's you can get through it and maybe come back to it later, but I actually wanted to come back to it after I listened to it a couple times. And I can't deny that this album feels smart and smooth and like her previous work, and that's why I give it 4 stars. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to tell me what you think of the album down below, and I'll see you next time.